So I would like to introduce you the best reason of our friendship with Dominique, Christina. I don't know what.
And briefly, Dominique has been very kind to be my friend. That's one way to put it. The other way to put it is, oh my God, we should totally be friends forever! And I kind of haven't left yet, so yeah. So when she decided to set this up, I was like, oh, that's wonderful. She's like, oh, we should totally stay. And I'm like, oh, why? And she and a couple other people have asked me like to sing gospel. I'm just like, what is with people wanting to hear gospel? I don't get it. But if you know Dominique, one of the most beautiful things about her is her faith. It's a very, very integral part of who she is. And she wears it with pride. She wears it very eloquently. And it's just very much a part of who she is. So I was like, you know what? I would be honored to offer a few gospel songs. So with that, I'm going to sing. The first song is called Precious Lord. Backstory behind it, I don't really know the whole backstory behind it, so I'm kind of new to this whole, it's like, just get up and sing thing. I sang when I was a kid, like when I was in choir and whatnot, but that was it, because my mom was like in the back, like taking pictures, and I had like the big, like, makeup on, like, woohoo! But what I do know of Precious Lord is that we normally sing it during funerals, and which sounds a little crazy to be singing it, you know, during a birthday party, but the words are, Precious Lord, take my hand. And the idea is that no matter what struggles you're going through, and you know, I wish Dominique a wonderful, beautiful coming year, because we don't get old, we get fabulous. But every now and then, the fabulosity rubs off a little bit, and you need to ask somebody for some help. So in those times, and like I said, Dominique wears her faith on her sleeve, one on her face, everywhere. That's when you talk to God. And the idea is that God will always take your hand if you ask him. So that's why I'm going to sing Precious Lord with my hand. And unfortunately, I have not memorized the words, so I'm going to be one of the unfortunate ones that has my will live with me. So. I'm sure you guys will forgive me. I'm not the one you guys came here to see. Two more things. One, I'm not stalling, I swear. This song was made famous by Mahalia Jackson. I am no Mahalia, like, I'm many things, but Mahalia is not one of them. When it comes to, like, the people who can really sing in my family, it's like my grandmother on my dad's side. And I used to be able to sing like that, but not anymore. But Mahalia Jackson made the song very famous because she sang it for Martin Luther King, and this is Martin Luther King's favorite song, and she sang it for his funeral. Aretha Franklin actually sang this song for Mahalia Jackson's funeral, and I want to say Leontine Price actually sang this for President Lyndon B. Johnson's funeral. So once again, it's a very famous song. Like I said, on one hand it's for funerals because the idea of God coming to take your hand when you're done with this life, and on the other hand, if you're having a bad day, it's nice just to know that God's going to take your hand.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me
precious Lord, linger near when my life is almost
songs. Like I said, it's usually for funerals and homecomings. But to me, if you have a bad day, it's just good to know someone's got your back. So. My second song, I only have two more, so I will not take up your time because I am not the main attraction. My second song is one of just, you know, everybody knows it, Amazing Grace. Just because who can come sing gospel and not sing Amazing Grace? You know, it's like, come on, it's like Amazing Grace, get you out your seats. Yes! I'm thinking like the Baptist choir where everyone's like, amazing, it's amazing, amazing, amazing. And you get the pastor out there and everyone's going, singing. So I can't do all that. I'm sorry. But I can at least sing a little bit of Amazing Grace for you.
Like me.
welcome everybody because, you know, this is birthday party. So. I need everyone to help me sing happy birthday. Aww. We are very lucky to be in this room, and there's like 80 million like languages in here. So I vote you sing it in your own language. I think the sentiment's what's important here. I'm going to start it off for us, right?
Go ahead.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Dominique. Happy birthday, à moi, Dominique.
Is 10 years ago. So let's hope I remember everything. If not, then please. I will be very sorry, but this is actually, I can tell you a whole lot of stories about it, but it's Ave Maria, so I think you will kind of recognize it. Maybe you can sing a lot more.
Thank you.
Человеческим. И, о чудо, тело Господне вкушают кроткие и смиренные духом.
Thank you.
мы с вами не расслабляемся. Итак. Выступает заслуженная артистка Сколковского технологического института Доминик Львов. Камиль Сен-Санс, соната ре минор.
So we have now come to the last piece of the program. The sonata is written in a sonata form, so there are four movements. However, what's special in this sonata is that they are separated into two parts. So the first two movements are fused together, and the last two movements are also fused together. Saint-Saëns was born in Paris in 1835, so much more in the same period as Elgar that we heard at the beginning. And he was a prodigious talent. He composed his first piece of music when he was 3, and he performed his first concert when he was 10, playing a Beethoven piano concerto. Some of his best-known works are the Carnival of the Animals and Danse Macabre. I'm sure that you have heard at least parts of the Carnival of the Animals. And his works have the overall characteristics of being very passionate, the presence of nostalgia and somewhat nonchalance, and so he varies a lot in his emotions, but he's very, very passionate in his music. So this sonata that you will hear, the first movement is the characteristic is the tension that you will feel through the whole movement, and it is shared between the piano and the violin. And throughout the whole sonata, there is not one instrument that is more important than the other. Both instruments really bounce off each other and help bring the music together. And then the first movement gives way to a much calmer second movement, which is almost out of time. You will feel that there's no... It almost feels as if it's written without a time signature. And then the second half of the work there's a scherzo, which is full of humor and very fun. And the last movement is I would call it a celebration of life. And once this starts, it doesn't stop. It's very fast, and we try to play together. This last movement. It's very fun. It's again one of my favorite pieces. I've been wanting to play this sonata for maybe 10 years, and now I finally get the chance to do it. So here it is for you. Thank you.
Yeah.